Good morning, everybody, and happy Wednesday to you. I was going to go and take off and go do my pickup rather, really early this morning, and then I realized that today is Wednesday, and I would have to go out and do a double pickup when a Filipino doctor was ready to get out of his office, but I don't know, I think I'm still going to do it anyway, even if it is to waste gas. It's just there's just so many things that need to be done. Got to deposit paychecks that arrived while I was gone. Got to take care of quite a few things. It is 8:32. I woke up starving this morning, but I guess with the time difference, it would be lunch hour. So maybe I will actually go and have something to eat already. I was going to say, that's just too early. I'm going to have to wait. I forced myself last night to stay up until almost midnight before I went upstairs, because if I didn't and if I just jammed up my sleep, it was just gonna F up my body, and can't do that. The bebe, I think she's pretty happy that I'm home. Mom and Scott said that she wasn't eating, that they threw away more food than she was actually eating. They would feed her, and because I had said, you know, if you feed her and she doesn't eat it, and it's, you know, her next meal time, just dump it. Don't wait for her to eat it. Just give her fresh stuff. And they said that she was barely eating anything and was kind of dumping stuff. And I did notice that she looked a little thinner. But I tell you what, when I headed like towards the kitchen, she jetted up in front of me, and I looked in, and I was like, "You've got food, you know." And I just let it go. Oh boy, when I finally did feed her, I have to feed her or something, because I fed her and she ate like crazy. And she hasn't stopped begging for treats, and I haven't actually given her any treats. I just continue to give her this, and I give her this one. It's, remember I told you that this was three packages for $3, so that it was like for the picky eater, so you could figure out which one of their brands of foods that they actually like. This is her favorite, but it's got the first ingredient is fish meal, so she can't have it on a regular basis. So I just give her a couple of chunks as treats, maybe about two or three times a day. Just nothing that is regular before she gets ill. So anyway, yeah, so that's what I've been giving her for treats, and it just seems to satisfy her. And tell you what, boy, she came right upstairs ready to sleep, and she stayed with me until I got up about 6:45. My body told me time to get up. I turned over, went to use the bathroom, thought I could go back to sleep, actually, and my body didn't allow me to, so I just went ahead and laid around for a little bit, then got up and said, yeah, time to get up and tackle the day. So, came down and went about, you know, my normal business with everything, like as if it had never changed. So, yeah, kind of bummed that it's over with, and got to get back to normal business and the work. I did kind of cringe slightly, just a tiny bit, when I thought, ugh, I've got to go pick up work and I've got to start. Yeah. That's the sucky part about getting back from vacation, you know? But anyway, day seven. I didn't have very much sleep, probably about 3.5 hours around there, and had to get up. The first shuttle that left the hotel was at 5 a.m. Now, my flight was at 6:15, and I was a little worried about that, because I knew that we were really close to the hotel, but I didn't know if, you know, getting there at that close, I don't know, it just worried me. Anyway, got there in more than enough time. It ended up being a taxi that they called instead of, the guy who worked there as their maintenance guy did shuttle also on top of everything else that he did. So got there. I was able to check in without too much of an issue. Just dragging 92 pounds. of suitcase behind me. It was quite ridiculous, if you ask me. When I left with 77 pounds. How did I trade off all the crap that I took with me and gave away and then end up with 92 pounds? And that was me being good. That was me being really good because I didn't know if I was going to be able to come home, you know, first class and be able to check in as much, you know, weight in my suitcase, you know, that I wanted to, because you're allowed two suitcases up to 70 pounds. Anyway, checked in, went through security, walked 14 miles till I got to my gate. The beauty part about when I was able to sleep a little tiny bit, actually, and I think more of that had to do with pure exhaustion rather than actual comfort, because Lord knows in those tiny little puddle jumpers you aren't allowed very much comfort. I was able to sleep maybe about 20, maybe 30 minutes max, but that was nice. But the good part about that is I landed in gate B and I took off from gate E, and the gate that I landed in was only 430 miles away from the main terminal where you get on the train in Houston to get to your next, you know, your next gate thingy. So I was only, 430 miles away? Yeah, it was only 430 miles away, as opposed to when I got there, it was 893 miles away. Because that's the thing I was worried about. I had a 45-minute gap from the time I landed until my next plane was boarding and getting ready to leave. And it was 45 minutes till boarding and an hour till I left. Something like that. Very close. And so I was able to get, I think, to the train within maybe about 20 minutes or so, and there wasn't any time to spare in between to pick up breakfast. So I got onto the train, and it got me to E, and we leave from the international area, so it's always the furthest possible gate from anything. I mean, we were like around things with like Cancun and Canada and all that stuff. Hawaii is international. traded in my currency even. So I got there with, you know, maybe about 5 minutes to spare, and I seriously thought about walking back the 14 miles to the mainer area where you could get near the Starbucks and stuff, and I thought, no, you know what, I'm not going to even play that game. So when I got onto the plane, the lovely part about first class is you sit down and they're like up your butts immediately almost. It's like, what do you want to drink, you know? And so I had some orange juice right off, and then got some coffee, and then we don't even get to cruising altitude before they're shoving food down your throat. They called it lunch, interestingly enough, even though we didn't get on the plane until like 9, I think we got on about 9:30, I think was the flight. And it was, all I saw was, so we had choices of tenderloin steak, and there was a chicken, and because the chicken came with rice, and my body was dying from rice withdrawal, I had an entire week of no rice in my body. because I saw that there was rice available, I didn't pay very much attention to how the chicken was prepared, and Lord have mercy, did I regret that. Not only was it dry as hell, it was, you know, a chicken breast, but it was curry flavored, and I'm not a fan of the curry, not a real huge fan of the curry. I can have little bits of it, just very, very little bits of it. So the lucky part was they prepared it with the skin on, so I was able to flap the skin off and get most of the curry flavor off of it. Anyway, so I had that, and it was jasmine rice, and the rice wasn't really that good, and then the zucchini was way overcooked, and then the first course was a packet of whole cashews, and then next we had the salad and fruits, I think, shrimps again, shrimps, this time with cocktail stuff. Oh, hi babe, let me move this stuff. And then the, yes, and then the chicken, and then the ice cream sundae again. I wasn't hungry at all for the ice cream sundae, but just to rub it in for Scott, I took it just to have two mouthfuls. Terrible and wasteful, right? But whatever. I paid for it. I was able to recline till like almost, I mean, you know, you're barely up. And I slept almost the entire way, seriously. Waking up just again in time. Well, I woke up in the middle of it and was served a freshly baked chocolate chip cookie. It was sitting waiting for me to wake up, still hot. And then I woke up again and they were serving cheeseburgers. And not just plain old funky cheeseburgers, but, you know, like the premium sesame buns with, you know, a thick sirloin burger, you know, being used for the beef. And yeah, it was lovely. It was wonderful being spoiled. I got home. Bebe, like I said, was still sleeping. They'd spent some time at the mall. And yeah, then got home and had barbecue for dinner. Go figure, right? So yeah, I got a couple of cookbooks, smaller cookbooks, and Tammy and Gigi and Rock gave me, you know, little ones. One was a vintage one. I gotta go through them, and I gotta, sadly, so many, you know, we all shared our gifts all at one time, and so there are some that kind of got mixed up with others, and I'm really gonna start making an effort to make these videos a lot shorter, but, you know, I have a lot to say. I might make another one again later and show you stuff. And I tried last night getting my videos together, but it just wasn't happening. There's something going on with my Sony Vegas where it doesn't like meshing. I think my pictures are too big, you know, that the Canon takes. Yes, my love. And so it has a hard time meshing the two. Say hi before you duck out. Oh, there's the beautiful face that we all know and love. Oh, I miss this girl. I really did. All right, you guys. I hope you have a wonderful day. I will talk to you later. Bye.